Selling your online course on your own Squarespace website gives you full control over every detail, how you present, market, and sell your content. In this video, I'll show you exactly how to get started. The first step is to develop your course content, and this is where you'll want to spend some time. So start by outlining the main topics that you'll cover, and then break them down into modules or sections that make sense for your students. So each module can include video lessons, downloadable materials like PDFs or worksheets, quizzes, and even certifications if you're offering them. Once your course content is ready, it's time to add it to your Squarespace website. So you can organize your course however you like. That's the beauty of using your own website. But if you're unsure of how to do it, here's a structure that I would recommend. So start by creating a page for each module. And on these module pages, list your lessons so that students have a clear overview of what's coming up. Each lesson should then have its own dedicated page. On these pages, place the video at the top and then a brief description of the lesson, as well as things like an estimate of how long it'll take to complete the lesson and links to any downloadable materials. For quizzes, create separate pages just like you did for the lessons. This keeps everything organized and easy for your students to follow. The last thing that you'll need to add to your lesson pages are navigation buttons, so next and back buttons that make it easy for your students to move through the course. Now, let's talk about organizing your URLs. Having a clear, logical URL structure is really important for both you and your students. So I suggest something like this: yoursite.com/members/module, yoursite.com/members/module/lesson, and so on. This keeps everything clean and makes it easy for you to find exactly what you're looking for. Next, you'll want to protect all of those course pages by adding a paywall to your website with a tool like MemberSpace. So this allows you to lock all of your course content so that only paying students can access it. And here's how to do it. All you'll have to do is take the URLs for the pages that you just created and add them right here. This way, your students have to create an account on your website, pay, and then be logged in anytime that they want to access your course content. Now with your content pages protected, it's time to set up your course pricing. So you've got a few options here. If you're selling the course on its own, a one-time payment might be the way to go. But if you're offering it as a part of a membership where you bundle it with other digital products and offerings, you can consider a recurring subscription payment. And then for high ticket courses, offering a payment plan or multiple payments can make it more affordable and appealing to a wider audience. Another great strategy is to offer the first lesson or two for free. This gives potential students a taste of your course and can be the nudge that they need to make the full purchase. Once your pricing is set, you'll receive a sign-up link, and this is the link that students will use to purchase your course. So you'll want to add this link to a purchase button on your website or really anywhere on your website, social media, emails that you want to promote your course. So when someone clicks it, they'll be prompted to sign up and pay for your course right then and there. Now that everything is set up, you're ready to start accepting payments and welcoming students to your course. Remember, this is just the beginning, and as you grow, you can always enhance your course by adding new content, bundling additional digital products, or even raising your prices as the value of your course increases. To keep your course competitive and valuable, think about ways you can continually add to it over time. So you might include a student forum for your students to interact, host live Q&A sessions, add expert interviews to your course, or even offer a library of supporting materials. Each of these adds layers of value that can justify a higher price and keep your students engaged over the long term. And there you have it. Thanks for watching, and let me know if you have any questions in the comments.